All right, I thought I'd just do this big video showing you how to strip the reel and give it a good service. There's nothing really wrong with the reel as such. The drag's not working as well as it should. It's a wee bit to really, really clamp it down. So I thought I'd just go through step by step what I do to my reels. I'm not saying it's gospel as such, but it's what I do. So the only difference is it's an aftermarket cage. Aside from that, it's pretty much bog standard. So start off taking off the right hand side plate. Generally I just tighten these down by thumb, but they haven't been undone in a while, so they're a wee bit tight, so we untighten. One of them jobs I like to do before the winter, because I use this reel for casting practice, so I tend to this gets a bit of salt water use, so I'm going to just give it a wee service and grease, re-greasing to keep it protected during the winter. Take the side plate off. Now the spindle didn't come out with the side plate because I don't keep the wee retainer on, because there's no need for it really. Take that off. Now, this can be a problem getting the spool out, because a lot of casters will generally fill the line right up to the edge of the spool. And the problem is it's hard to get this out of here. So, unfortunately, what I'm going to have to do is, I'm going to have to take a wee bit of line off. So, we'll speed this up. We'll take a bit of line off. So, there's the spool out. I have to pull a wee bit of line off, just because, as I said before, a lot of casters will generally fill the spool right up to the very lip, so it makes it awkward to get this out. So I'll set the spool to one side for now. Unfortunately, there's a lot of line. I'll take the other side plate off. Just a Phillips style screwdriver, and again, these shouldn't really be too tight, because it's very, very easy to round the screws. So generally I just do them thumb tight with this, and then just nip them up very slightly with the screwdriver. Take those three screws off. And there's an aftermarket mag unit in this. It's a Chris Macy conversion. And they Black Dog speed bullet. And as you can see, I've put a bit of epoxy in there just to keep the slider in place. So that to the side as well. So the main concern for most people is just dismantling this and taking this all apart, but it's fairly straightforward. So all we'll do is, generally I'll get a wee tray to keep the parts in as well. So take off the handle retainer, handle plate. In this case, it's a wee Phillips again. And take the wee handle plate off. And then nearly all ABBA reels are a 10mm hex socket. Take the nut off. Now, this can be the fiddly wee thing. This wee C-clip here, top of the drive shaft, it can be awkward to get off and get on as well. And sort of keep your thumb on it and just try to put the screwdriver in the wee gap and sort of twist it off. But if you're not careful, it'll go flying, so you need to be very careful. There we go, there's it off. Then off comes the handle and the washer, star drag washer, and take our star drag off. Now, what we'll do is we'll start disassembling the brake plate side, which is this side. So again, we Phillips screwdriver, undo the two screws. One, two. Now what you'll find here is, when you lift this off, there'll be some parts left in here. It's the two wee spring washers that are part of the drag, so just knock them out. There we go. And you're left with the inner workings of the rail. So what I'll tend to do now, I'll get a wee tray. I'm not going to bother cleaning this. I'll give this a wee wash in some cold running water, but it's relatively new, so I'm the same with this. This doesn't really need any attention. Sometimes what I'll do is just get a wee light bit of motor grease and just rub it around the inside just to get a wee bit of protection. But aside from that, it's more the right-hand side plate is the bit that needs serviced. So I've actually put on a wee pair of gloves because I'm actually cooking later, so I don't want to have the food all covered in grease. So you should be able to just lift off your the drive shaft, easy enough, just like that. Now, I'll zoom in here a wee bit. When the drive shaft comes off, there should be a tiny wee brass washer at the bottom of the drive shaft post. Where's my screwdriver? So I'll just pull it, wedge it off. There we go. It'll be a bit fiddly. That post is absolutely stinking as well. So this is the way the drive shaft works. You've a wee collar that fits in the anti-reverse bearing. Pull the wee collar off. And all the drag washers. Now generally try to keep these in order, but I know what way they go, so I'll show you on reassembly. The drive shaft and the main gear, and then underneath the main gear there's another wee washer. Okay, so that's our drive shaft and drag washers. Now the other bit is the spring that holds the clutch down, works the clutch down. When you push that in, it lifts it up, lifts up the pinion gear. And then when you turn the handle, it pushes that back and it springs it back down. So all you need to do, this is just clipped on, this clutch spring. So you basically just unclip it there, and it comes off. And then your pinion holder, which is this plastic thing in the middle, this just slides out. Like so, and then there's three parts to the clutch. You have the actual the button itself, the return or the re-engagement bit, and the wee, this wee thing here. Oh, and also there's a wee spring here. Some rails don't have this spring. Some rails have the spring actually built in to this. So I'll take that spring off. Okay, so that's it all disassembled. And we'll make our way to the garage and start cleaning them up and degreasing them. And then relube them, etc. And show you how to reassemble. Okay, we'll start with the spool. I've pulled the spindle out. There's the spindle out. So we just get a wee precision flat screw, flat headed. And just put it underneath the clip. And hold your thumb on it to stop it flying away on you. And then prise it off. It's proving to be more tricky than I thought. I think, yes it is actually. There we go, that's it off. And then take the drive plate off. Now, see, this is the problem with too much line on the spool. Probably should have put a bit of tape on that, but anyway. So I'm gonna get the, usually I have a wee bearing puller, but I don't have one, so tap the bearings out, pull them out with a spindle if it works. If not, maybe get a paper clip or something. So we'll get a wee tin here, put the two bearings in, and get some, I use carburetor cleaner. You can see them. We spray in there. So just let them soak in the fluid. Carry on with something else. Now, ideally what you want to do is take the brake plate, degrease it, clean it up with some fairy liquid, dry it off or rinse it off with warm water and let it dry. But this is quite a new plate and it's actually, there's no corrosion on it at all, as you can see. So the main problem I had was the drag was slipping a wee bit, so I'm just going to give this a wipe down. Doesn't really need to be. There's no marks on it at all. It's as new. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to degrease the main gear, the drive shaft, all the drag washers, collar, clutch mechanism, and the pinion gear. I'm not going to put these plastic bits in because I find they get discoloured by the carburetor cleaner for some reason. So I'm just going to give them a wee wipe off. So we'll give them a wee tint. Shit, that one's been used before. Got a fresh one here. So I'm going to put in the main gear, drive shaft, drag washers, all of them, pinion gear, clutch mechanism, the three parts to it, the wee collar that goes fits into the anti-reverse bearing, and the wee brass washer that goes in the bottom of the drive shaft post. And I'll spray a bit of cleaner into them too. Now what you can do is you want to give them a really deep clean. You get like a wee a hair shaver and just hold it against it, so it gives it like a sort of ultrasonic cleaner effect. So let's give it a wee soak for a while in the carb cleaner. Come back in a moment. Like I said, the cage, it's pretty clean as it is. Just going to give it a wee soak in some hot soapy water and then give it a good rinse. Right hand side plate. There's a wee bit of grease inside it. I'm not going to bother soaking it because I don't want to get moisture into the anti-reverse bearing, which is in there. So we'll just give it a clean out with some rag. Plus I don't mind a bit of surface grease in there to keep it protected against the elements. Okay, so my drag set and gears have been soaking in this carb cleaner, so I'm just going to take them out. They're all nice and clean. No grease on them. Just put them out in a clean bit of paper to dry off. You should have drive shaft, main gear, three parts to your clutch. If I can get it out. Yeah, it's making a noise. Three parts of your clutch. You should have your reverse, anti-reverse collar, your pinion gear. You should have three metal drag washers. One, two, three. You should have four four. One, two, three, four. Four black drag washers. And finally your wee brass collar. Or the brass washer, sorry. Yeah, it's proving a wee awkward to get out, so I'll have to... There we go. So let them dry off for a bit. Let that all evaporate away. And we'll go back to our bearings. There's our bearings there. Okay. So I'll give all these parts a good half hour to dry off and evaporate away all the cleaner. Okay, now we come to reassembly. I just generally use motor grease. I don't really use any oils apart from a bit of oil, tiny drop of oil in the bearings. Some people do use oils, but I prefer to just use a bit of grease because I feel it stays on a bit better, especially if you're using the rail in the sea and stuff. So first thing you want to do is get your brake plate. I put a tiny wee dab of grease at the bottom of the post, drive shaft post. Okay, then we take our very small brass washer and it goes over the post. There we go. Next, we take our drive shaft. Again, I'll put a tiny wee dab of grease in the bottom of it as well. And it slides onto the post. There we go. Then we take the smallest drag washer, or the wee black one, the small black one. It goes over the shaft. Then comes the main gear. Now, I don't lubricate these bits at all because you don't need to, and it gives you a far better drag set. So first thing goes on is a black drag washer, or drag plate should I say, then a drag washer, another drag plate, then the drag washer with the two wee ears on it fits into there, another drag plate, and finally the other drag washer, which you can see it faces that way up. So that's that on. Now, what we'll do now, get a bit more grease. I just put a tiny bit of grease on the plate here. With a clutch mechanism, slides in and out. Tiny bit in that post, tiny bit in that post. A wee bit in that post, and a wee bit in that post. That's all I really do, really. That's not going to be anything. Okay, so now we'll fit the clutch mechanism. So first bit on is the speed boil here, goes under the right hand post. As in, that's the left one, that's the right one. Then the button goes there. And then finally, the release mechanism goes on top. Like so. Tiny wee dab of grease. Now where's my spring? This wee spring can be very fiddly. The spring goes over that post and hooks onto that wee hook. As I said, some of them don't have a spring. Some do, some don't. This is just a wee edit that I forgot to mention to put some grease just on here. Just put a wee bit on there. A wee bit on there, that's just where it slides in, and then a wee bit under here too, where this slides. Pinion gear. Tiny wee bit of grease in there. And then the pinion gear slots in this way with the drive shaft end down, or the drive end down, should I say. So it all goes together like that. So next thing to do is the spring mechanism. So you want to make sure they're all flat. This clips onto that post, and the other bit clicks onto the post where the wee spring is. Sometimes it takes a wee bit of a push. Just make sure your button's not in the way when you do it as well. So I should be able to push the button in, lift the pinion gear up, and then turn the handle, brings it back down. I don't know if you can see that. Lift it up, turn the handle, lift it back down. Okay. Now, greasing of the main gears, I don't really put much on because it ends up very messy very quick. So I just put a wee bit on a cotton bud and just put a wee bit on the main gear, which will rub off onto the pinion anyway. And if you put too much on, it's going to end up getting all over the drag and stuff as well. So I don't think that's too much, to be honest. Plus, in a way, they're sort of self-lubricating, the type of metal they're made of. That'll do. Okay, so next thing, get our side plate. Oh yes, I forgot to mention one more thing. We better grease the anti-reverse bearing. Some people will say put loads in, but it doesn't really get much pressure. My part, because I'm just casting with it. You know, if you're fishing, maybe, I don't know. So this slides on to your under here, and before you push it down tight, just look at the side, make sure the button's in the recess. That's good and down tight. And we'll get our two screws. And just do them finger tight first. And the other one. And then just nip them up. Not tight at all, just very sort of, because you don't want to wrap these as well. I'll do. Alright, next thing. First thing that goes on is the collar, which, if I can find it, which is here. The wee collar. It slides on over the drive shaft. Either way up is fine, I think. Leave it. It's that on. Next thing is the two washers. Now, these have to be right, because if they're not right, the drag doesn't work. They're curved, so they should be curved away from each other. So the bottom one I'm putting on is curving that way, down, curving down. And the top one is curving up, like that. So just remember, they should always be curved away from each other. Okay. Next thing to go on is our drag wheel. And then the drag washer, which should be, according to Abbott, should face down top of the drag washer, or drag wheel, sorry. Then our handle. Then our wee clip, which can be awkward. This wee clip here. and just tend it, put it in place, and then bash it in with the end of a screwdriver. Taking care not to stab yourself with the other end of the screwdriver. And it's not playing ball. Being a booker. There we go, clicked in. Next are handle lock. And to be honest, you shouldn't really tighten these up very tight at all, because they're generally steel nuts on the soft brass drive shaft. So just till you feel it and no more is all you really need, because the plate holds it in position anyway, so it's not going to loosen. It needs a tiny, tiny wee turn just to line the hole up. That's what, if you tighten up too much and you end up having to tighten it more to fit the hole, then you're screwed. And then the wee screw goes in. Retaining screw in. Just check it all works. Button in. Drag feels good. Although I can't tell really yet until it's on the rail. So only thing to do is put the bearings back in. Now the bearings have been cleaned in lighter fuel or carb cleaner. So we don't need any grease in them at all for casting. What I use is rocket fuel, TG's rocket fuel. I've had a bottle of this for about 7 years and it's still more than half full. These are ABEC 5 bearings, stainless steel. A lot of people will use 7s or sometimes even 9s, but my preference is ABEC 5 all steels. They don't need much oil at all because it'll slow them down too much. So what I do is just dab a wee bit of oil on the tip of a screwdriver, and then very slightly just touch the bearing so a wee bit of oil goes into it. Like I said, you don't need much at all for these. Too much will definitely slow them down. Nope. That's all I'm gonna put in those. Pop the bearing in. Oh, sometimes there'll be a wee washer in here. This is the drive shaft side, the drive side. Sometimes there'll be a wee spacer washer. I tend to just leave them in, to be honest. Pop the old bearing in. Put the drive plate on, and then these are aftermarket clips, which are a lot stronger, from Black Dog. Just try to make sure they're. Get those over the, these can be fiddly as well because they're upgraded clips. So what you want to do is just make sure it's, focus you. Make sure it's not really showing. If it's showing at the edges, then you know it's not fully in position. That. Pop the other bearing in. So what I'm going to do now is pull this line back off to get the spool back in. So back a minute. Okay, so there's the spool back in the cage, which was a bit of a nightmare. Spindle, generally don't need lubricated at all, because they're not turning. But what I tend to do, as a rule of thumb, is just put a tiny smear of oil on it, and the reason for that being, depending on what bearings you use, sometimes the inner race isn't a good fit, and if it's slightly loose at the start of the cast, the inner race can spin or skid on the shaft, on the spindle. So that tiny bit of oil just creates more of a tighter tolerance, and I find it keeps it a little bit quieter at the start of the cast. So make sure the bullet's fine. Good, nice fit. Sometimes if it rocks about in a bit, I'll put a wee bit of grease on the outside of it just to tighten it up. So put the bowl on. Or put the side plate on, should I say. Three screws. And like I said earlier, I used to do these by hand first. It's always too easy to over tighten and damage these screws. They're pretty much hand tight. And then I just give them a wee nip up. Eighth of a turn, quarter of a turn. So all I've got to do now is put the drive shaft, drive side on. Again, most people just thumb these up. I tend to thumb them and then give them a wee nip up with a screwdriver. Right, where's the flathead? Hand tight and then not even a quarter of a turn. So let's put this line back on. Let's land on the floor here. Okay, so there's the line back on. Give the mags wind off and give this a wee spin. Just make sure it's, and see the drag's much, much better now since they've been cleaned of grease. That was the tape making a noise. There we go, purring like a pussycat. Now personally me, I tend not to get too concerned about excessive spin times. Works for some people. Me myself, if it spins more than a minute or 2 minutes, I'm happy enough. At the end of the day, cast really lasts 7 or 8 seconds and you're on mag for the first four at least, winding them off. Possibly if it was going to a world championship, I'd be looking at a reel that runs freer, but for general club use, I'm happy enough if a reel runs for 2 or 3 minutes. So I'm very impressed with how much the drag has just improved. 10 times, I can barely turn that, holding the spool. So the drag's considerably increased. So that's all I do, really. So take from it what you will. All right, all the best.